If a ball is performing pure rolling motion and there is no deformation, then we don't expect any frictional force to act, and there is no reason for the ball to stop at all. So the ball should continue to move. However, in reality, we know that any ball does stop on its own after some time. Therefore, there must be some force acting so as to reduce the velocity of the center of mass. That's how comes the concept of rolling friction. Along with rolling friction, the normal reaction helps in stopping the ball as well. Out of the two players, one decreases the velocity of the center of mass and the other decreases angular velocity. Consider a ball which is moving towards right side, and therefore its angular velocity must be like this. Normally, we say that the normal reaction passes through the center of mass. However, in reality, the front part of the ball presses the ground harder, shifting normal reaction towards the right side. I have tried to show the normal reaction shifted towards the right side. Gravitational force is shown acting from center of mass. The curvature which you see here, this won't be spherical, it would be deformed. Let me try to show the deformation using some other color. So imagine this to be somewhat flat and normal reaction passing from the right side in this manner. Due to the deformation, there are stresses and there is a frictional force acting in this manner. This is not static, this is not kinetic, though there may be some slipping involved as well due to the deformation. This is the frictional force of deformation. Frictional force of deformation is called rolling friction. Rolling friction acts in the left side direction. Center of mass is moving in the right side direction. So it is this friction which decreases VCM. So VCM decreases. But how about omega? The normal reaction produces a torque which tries to oppose omega. So the frictional force decreases VCM and the normal reaction decreases omega. That is how a rolling ball comes to a halt. What is the magnitude of this rolling friction? Rolling friction is mu times normal reaction divided by the radius. So what is interesting here is to note that mu cannot be dimensionless. Left side is force, normal reaction is force. So obviously mu must have the dimensions of length.